today we are going to meditate the word of God. How many of you remember the last Sunday message? Okay, thank God, no one. Amen. Okay, oh, so okay, some people. Okay, do you remember the verse which I started with the message? I'm not talking about the message, the verse which I started. 2 Samuel 3:1. Very good. Thank you. Anand, thank you. We can read that verse again. Today's message is the continuation of last week's message. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, 2 Samuel chapter 3, verse 1. The mic on, please. Okay.
Now there was a long war between the house of Saul and the house of David. But David grew stronger and stronger, and the house of Saul grew weaker and weaker.
David grew stronger and stronger, and the house of Saul grew weaker and weaker. One person grew stronger and stronger. The other person and his household grew weaker and weaker. Amen. Last week we meditated why David became stronger and stronger, why Saul became weaker and weaker. Okay. We found on the basis of scripture, we found how many spirits made him weak? Nine spirit or eight spirit? Nine, okay. If she tells, it will be right. Okay, hallelujah. How many spirit? Nine spirit which made Saul weaker. We found that from the scriptures. So we should keep ourselves away from all this type of nine evil spirit. Hallelujah. God wants to strengthen us all the time. At the same time, enemy wants us to weaker. Hallelujah. That is the plan of the enemy. Hallelujah. When you are weak, you cannot do anything. When you are weak, you cannot reach the destiny. That is the plan of the enemy. Why enemy wants to make us weak? Because the plan of the enemy is you should not reach your destiny. You should not fulfill the plan of God in your life. You should not fulfill the purpose of God in your life. Amen. Who chose King Saul? God chose him. The people asked for a king, but God's choice was Saul. God chose him as a king. God chose him with a purpose. God put him in that kingdom with a purpose, with a plan. But the enemy made him weaker. Finally, he could not continue the purpose of God in his life. Hallelujah. He had to lose the kingdom because he allowed the evil spirit in his life. Because of that, Saul became weaker. Hallelujah. But the same scenarios, same challenges, David also faced. But David handled those things in a different way. Saul failed to handle the situations the way. Hallelujah. That's why he grew weaker, but David grew stronger. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Okay. Today we are going to see about the strength of Caleb. Last week we saw that strength of David. Today strength of Caleb. Okay. Joshua chapter 14, 5 to 13. Joshua chapter 14, verses 5 to 13.
As the Lord had commanded Moses, so the children of Israel did, and they divided the land. Then the children of Judah came to Joshua in Gilgal, and Caleb the son of Jephunneh and Kenizzite said to him, "You know the word which the Lord said to Moses, the man of God, concerning you and me in Kadesh Barnea. I was 40 years old when Moses, the servant of the Lord, sent me from Kadesh Barnea to spy out the land. And I brought back word to him as it was in my heart. Nevertheless, my brethren who went up with me made the heart of the people melt. But I wholly followed the Lord my God. So Moses swore on that day, saying, surely the land where your foot has trodden shall be your inheritance and your children's forever. Because you have wholly followed the Lord my God. And now behold, the Lord has kept me alive. And he said, these 45 years, ever since the Lord spoke his words to Moses while Israel wandered in the wilderness, and now here I am this day. 85 years old.
Mm.
And yet I am as strong this day as on the day Moses sent me, just as my strength was then. So now is my strength for war, both for going out and for coming in.
Mm.
Now therefore, give me this mountain of which the Lord spoke in that day.
Mm.
For you heard in the day how the Anakim were there, and that the cities were great and fortified. I may be that the Lord will be with us, and I shall be able to drive them out, as the Lord said.
Mm.
And Joshua blessed them and gave Hebron to Caleb, the son of Jephunneh, as an inheritance.
Amen. Hallelujah. I hope you all know this incident. After Moses' period, Joshua led the people of God into the land of Canaan. Then he started to divide the land to every tribe. That time Caleb came to Joshua. Caleb said, when you and me went to spy the land, we came with a different news. That time Moses gave us the promise to inherit the land. Moses promised us that he will give the land. Then the verse 11, Caleb said, we can read the verse 11 again. That is the important verse. Verse 11, it says, as yet I am as strong this day as on the day that Moses sent me, just as my strength was then. Now is my strength for war, both for going out and for coming in. Here Caleb is telling, I have the same strength, just as my strength was then. When Moses promised Caleb, he was 40 years old. Now Caleb is talking to Joshua. Now his age is 85 years. How many years he retained his strength? 45 years retaining the strength. Amen. Receiving a strength is one thing. Retaining the strength is another thing. Amen. Sometimes our strength is only one day. Only for Sunday. Amen. Tomorrow the Monday is a different day. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. If I'm in the church, I'm fine. I'm receiving a strength. Okay. Okay. If I want to have the service every day so that you all can receive a strength, you won't show up. Okay, only for Sunday, Pastor. No middle of the weekdays. Amen. It's fine. It's fine. I can read. But Bible says Caleb was able to retain the strength of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. If you are able to retain your strength, that means you can grow in the strength of God. Hallelujah. David grew stronger and stronger. Caleb had a strength of God, 45 long years. Amen. Hallelujah. Sometime I will tell the ministry team people, right? I can see a difference when I was in 30s. Right? Now I'm in 20s. I'm weak. Right? Okay, sorry. I'm in 40s now. Okay, but I feel weak. Right? I couldn't climb the steps very fast, right? It's aching like that. But my wife will always tell, run, don't do like that. Okay? She is expecting me to be strong. She is expecting, 20, amen, yeah. Praise the Lord, hallelujah. Amen. All the wives likes their husband to be 20s. Amen, hallelujah. But the husband should not expect the wives to be 20. You know, no, we are weak now. You need to help, you need to carry. Hallelujah, amen. But Caleb retained the strength of God. Hallelujah. For what? Why he retained the strength? Why he kept the strength of God? The next verse he said, now this is the time to possess the land. He was waiting 45 years with the strength of God. Not just waited. He had that strength of God and he was waiting to possess the land. Amen. When Moses promised 45 years before. Having a promise and waiting to inherit the promise, you need to have the strength of God. Then only you can inherit the land or inherit the promises. Amen. Hallelujah. If you lose the strength, you cannot inherit the promises of God. Hallelujah. Why you need to retain the strength? To inherit. to possess, to inherit the promises of God, prophecies of God. Amen? Hallelujah. Why you need the strength of God? To inherit the promises of God. Hallelujah. Then only you can inherit. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Just tell your neighbor, you will inherit. Tell your neighbor, not yourself. Tell your neighbor. Have eye contact with them and said, you will inherit. You will inherit. You will inherit all the promises of God. Tell your neighbor. Amen. You will inherit all the promises of God. Hallelujah. Amen. So, retain your strength. Is it the retain is the right word? I think so. Okay. Keep your strength. Amen. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, grow stronger. Grow stronger. Amen. Hallelujah. You have the strength of God. Tell your neighbor, you have the strength of God. Then the faith will increase in their life. Amen. God wants to increase the strength. Amen. God wants to retain your strength so that you can inherit the promises of God in your life. Amen. Because Bible says, who has promised you is faithful to fulfill it. Amen. How many of you believe that? Amen. Because he will never, never, never change in his word. The heaven will go away, disappear. The earth will disappear. But his word will never, never go in vain. Amen. Hallelujah. So that God wants to encourage you this morning, retain your strength. Hallelujah. Have your strength. Amen. How many of you believe that God has given a strength in your life? Amen. That's why God wants to tell you, you are strong in me. Amen. Many times we are telling, Lord, I am weak. But the truth is, you have a strength of God. Because you have Jesus inside of you. Jesus himself, the strength. Amen. That's why David said in Psalm 18 verse 1, you are my strength. Who is your strength? Jesus is strength. Amen. Amen. If you have Jesus in your life, that means you have strength. Hallelujah. You are not a weak person. Many times the enemy is telling, you are not strong enough. You are weak. You are weak. But the truth is, you have Jesus. You have strength of God. Amen. Hallelujah. There is a song, right? You are my? When I'm weak. We sang that song, right? Shall we sing together one more time? Amen. You are my strength when I am weak. You are my. Give a mic to Suma. My all in all. Let us all sing together. உங்களை நம்புனா அவ்வளவுதான்.
You are my strength when I am weak. You are the treasure.
Just tell them, Lord, you are my strength.
You are my all in all. Seeking you as a precious jewel. Lord, to give up, I'd be a fool. You are my all in all. Jesus, Lamb of God, worthy is your name.
Everyone to close your eyes for a minute. Everyone close your eyes. Maybe when you enter into this church, or maybe this morning you felt like that you are a weak person. Maybe you are telling yourself, or you told God, Lord, I did not have any strength to go further. But this morning, God wants to encourage you. God wants to tell you, I am your strength. You have my strength. You are not a weak person. You have my strength. That is the truth of God. Because you have Jesus inside of you. Amen. You are not a weak person. That's a lie of the enemy. You have a strength of God to inherit all the promises of God in your life. Amen. Let us all close our eyes. Just Suma will sing that one stanza. Hallelujah. Let us join with her and sing together by closing our eyes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Amen.
You are my strength when I am
just
weak.
Tell him, you are my strength.
You are the treasure.
Hallelujah. Now you can close your, open your eyes. Amen. Hallelujah. Okay. Caleb retained the strength of God. Amen. The question is how he was able to retain the strength of God. When I am not able to retain the strength for 1 week or 1 day or few days, how Caleb was able to retain the strength 45 long years. There were some secrets of Caleb's life that made him to retain the strength of God. I want to share about those things. Okay, how Caleb was able to retain the strength of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Joshua chapter 14, verses 7 and 8.
I was 40 years old when Moses, the servant of the Lord, sent me from Kadesh Barnea to spy out the land. And I brought back word to him as it was in my heart.
Okay, first reason, Caleb said, when I was 40, I was sent by Moses to spy the land. When I came back, I brought back word to him as it was in my heart. First of all, Caleb knew what to speak. Caleb knew whatever he has in his heart, he was able to speak out. Amen. Many times we fail to do this. Hallelujah. We will have one thing in our heart, but we are not speaking out. Bible says 12 spies went to land of Canaan. 10 people came with a different news. Only Joshua and Caleb had a different news. The 10 people spread the bad news. They said, we cannot overcome. We cannot possess the land. We cannot inherit the land. All negative things. But Caleb and Joshua took a different stand. They said, Caleb said, whatever it was in my heart, I shared it. I told it. Amen. Hallelujah. Many times we will hesitate to speak for the truth. Even though we know the truth, we will be quiet. We will hesitate, right? Amen. Or we will wait for others. Right? For sometime, for a small group, I will ask everyone to share. What is your opinion? What do you think in your heart? Amen. Some people will tell like that. Some people will wait for everyone. If everyone say yes, 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 then they will also say yes. If everyone say no, 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 they will also no. Hallelujah. Do you understand what I say? Amen. They won't tell their opinion. They will wait and they will lean on their other opinions. Amen. Hallelujah. That means double standard life. Hallelujah. Why you are quiet? Hallelujah. Amen. Okay. Hallelujah. Okay, if I point out someone, doesn't mean he. Okay, general. Okay, hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. We fail to take a stand. We fail to say the truth. We are manipulating. Do you understand? Caleb never manipulated the truth of God. Caleb recognized the Lord is with us. Amen. Caleb recognized the Lord is with him. He's told it. If the Lord is with us, easily we will overcome this land. Hallelujah. Amen. First of all, we should know how to express our heart. We should not play double standard life. Hallelujah. Telling one thing, pleasing people. Caleb did not want to please the 10. 10 people one side, the another side, Joshua. Now Caleb needs to take a stand, whether he needs to stand with Joshua or 10. 10 is majority, 1 is minority. Right? Many times we tempt to lean on to the majority. Hallelujah. Let me go with the flow. Let me go with the crowd. All the 10 destroyed. Hallelujah. The reason Caleb retained the strength, he shared whatever he had is in his heart. Hallelujah. That's the one reason he was able to retain the strength. Amen. Hallelujah. Then that's why God said, my son Caleb has a different spirit. God said, my son Caleb, my servant Caleb had a different spirit. When you have a different spirit, you will not manipulate the things. Amen. The different spirit the Lord mentioned is the spirit of the Lord. Hallelujah. The second reason, Caleb retained the strength in the next verse, verse 8. Mm.
Nevertheless, my brethren who went up with me made the heart of the people melt, but I wholly followed the Lord my God.
Amen. Here the Bible says, nevertheless, my brethren who went up with me made the heart of the people melt. The group of 10 melt the heart of the people. In midst of that situation, he said, I follow the Lord with all my heart. Amen. He said, majority melt the heart of the people, but I was the one follow the Lord with all my heart. That means even though the situation is bad, even though the majorities went away from God, still you can take a stand for the Lord. Amen. Caleb took a stand for the Lord. What was the stand? I will follow my God with all my heart. Amen. Doesn't matter who is coming with me or not, but I will follow the Lord with all my heart. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We need to take a stand for the Lord. Caleb took a stand for the Lord. That helped him to retain the strength of God. Amen. Hallelujah. 1 Samuel chapter 17 verses 23 and 24. How David took the stand for the Lord. Amen. Even though he was alone like Caleb, he took a stand for the Lord. Amen. 1 Samuel chapter 17 verses 23 and 24.
Then as he talked with them, there was the champion, the Philistine of Gath, Goliath by name, coming up from the armies of the Philistines. And he spoke according to the same words. So David heard them. And all the men of Israel, when they saw the man, fled from him and were dreadfully afraid.
Amen. Everybody, every warrior, including King Saul, everybody afraid of the giant Goliath. Bible says everybody fled away. Everybody fled away. But Bible says in verse 32. Verse 32. 1 Samuel chapter 17 verse 32.
Then David said to Saul, let no man's heart fail because of him. Your servant will go and fight with the Philistine.
Let no man's heart fail because of him. Your servant will go and fight with this Philistine. Who will go? Your servant means David. I will go and fight this Philistine. Amen. It doesn't matter whether who is coming with me or not, but I will go and fight this Philistine. Hallelujah. David was single. David was one person that time, but he took a stand. Amen. Hallelujah. Then he went and faced giant Goliath. Hallelujah. We can read the verse and one more scripture in the Bible. 1 Kings chapter 18 verse 21 and 22. 1 Kings chapter 18 verses 21 and 22. How Elijah took a stand for the Lord. Whoever takes a stand for the Lord, they will retain the strength of God. David took a stand for the Lord. He grew stronger and stronger. Caleb took a stand for the Lord. He retained the strength. Elijah took a stand for the Lord. And he received the strength. Wait a minute, Ma. Elijah took a stand for the Lord. He gained the strength. Amen. We can read now. Okay. 1 Samuel chapter 8. 1 King 18 verse 21 and 22.
And Elijah came to all the people and said, how long will you falter between two opinions? If the Lord is God, follow him. But if Baal, follow him. But the people answered him not a word. Then Elijah said to the people, I alone am left a prophet of the Lord. But Baal's prophet are 450 men.
Amen. See, how many people in Elijah's side? Only one. How many people in the other side? 400 and 50 people. If I was in Elijah's place, I will tell myself, I don't want this headache. Amen. Let me go along with this 450. Let me be the 451. But God doesn't call you to be one among the 450. God has called you to take a stand for the Lord and stand for God. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Maybe you feel like that you are left alone. Maybe you feel like that you are left alone. But take a stand for the Lord. Stand for God. Then something will happen in your life. Amen. Hallelujah. He took a stand. What happened in his life, in Elijah's life? 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 37. 1 Kings chapter 18.
Hear me, O Lord, hear me, that this people may know that you are the Lord God and that you have turned their hearts back to you again.
Amen. What Elijah prayed? Hear, O Lord, hear me. He did not say, hear us, O Lord, hear us, O Lord. Do you know the difference? He said, hear me, O Lord, hear me, O Lord. He left alone. But Bible says, the Lord sent the fire when he prayed, hear me, O Lord, hear me, O Lord. To how many people God answered? One. Why? He took a stand. When you take a stand for the Lord, God will answer your prayer. You don't need a group of people to pray for you. You don't need a group of people to bring a fire. By hearing your voice, God can bring a fire. Amen? Because God is watching over you. Whenever you take a stand, God is watching over you. God knows my son is standing alone there and taking a stand for me. My daughter is taking a stand for me. Amen? So I need to answer his prayer or her prayer. I need to send a fire because of his prayer, not because of the group. Hallelujah. Amen. If you read the 1 Kings chapter 19, 1 Kings chapter 19, I think verse 4 and 5.
But he himself went a day's journey into the wilderness and came and sat down under a broom tree. And he prayed that he might die and said, it is enough. Now, Lord, take my life, for I am no better than my fathers.
Who prayed? The same Elijah. Amen. One day before, he brought the fire from above. Amen. He took a stand. Okay, he prayed, the fire came. But 1 Kings chapter 19, Jezebel entered. Amen. Whenever you take a stand for the Lord, the Jezebels will come. Amen. Hallelujah. Why? Why Jezebels comes? Jezebel won't test you. Jezebel will kill you. Hallelujah. Amen. The Lord will test you. Jezebel, don't take it lightly. Okay, you cannot pass the test of Jezebel. Jezebel will finish your life, but hallelujah, the Lord will give you strength. Amen. Hallelujah. Jezebel saw this one man took a stand and killed all my prophets. This one man took a stand and killed all my 450. So you will face Jezebel. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. The Jezebel always will try to chase you out. Hallelujah. It's a dominating spirit. Hallelujah. The Jezebel is a threatening spirit. If you read the first two verses from 1 Kings 19, 1 and 2.
And Ahab told Jezebel all that Elijah had done.
And Ahab told Jezebel. Husband went and report to the wife. Do you know what happened? Do you know this happened, that happened? Blah, 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 blah. Everything. It's a good husband or bad husband? I don't know. Okay, good husband. Okay. Anyway, I don't want to get into that matter. Okay. Hallelujah. Sometimes the husband needs to be very wise what to share to the wife. Amen. Hallelujah. That is the wisdom of God. Ahab didn't. Okay. Streaming is there. Okay. Okay. Go ahead, Ma.
And how he had executed all the prophets.
Well,
with
the
sword.
Reason I'm telling, sometimes the husbands can handle the things easily. The wives cannot handle the things. That's the reason. I'm not saying you need to hide and drink alcohol. No, no, no. Not like that. Sometimes you can bear the shocking news. You can handle the things in a different way. The wives cannot do that because they are weak vessels. The Bible says, I did not say. Amen. Hallelujah. Sometimes they will cry immediately. They will call the person immediately. Amen. They will talk to them. Blah, 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 blah. That's it. See, Jezebel behaved like that. You can read.
Then Jezebel sent a messenger to Elijah saying, so let the gods do to me and more also, if I do not make your life as the life of one of them by tomorrow about this time.
Who sent a messenger? Jezebel. Which she was not at all in the scene. Many times the Jezebel won't be in the scene. But they will be able to send the message. Do you know what happened? Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. That's a Jezebel spirit. Jezebel spirit will bring confusion. Amen. Jezebel spirit will send the messenger unnecessarily. Jezebel spirit will send messages unnecessarily. WhatsApp, text, Facebook. Unnecessary messages. To cause confusion. Amen. To kill the spirit of the Lord inside the man of God's life. That's why we need to be very, very, very careful. We are not supposed to do all these things. God has not called you to behave like Jezebel. Jezebel was one of the chosen king's wife. But King Ahab and Jezebel failed. Right? That's why it caused confusion. It created confusion among the man of God. Hallelujah. We need to be careful what kind of messages we are sending. What kind of messenger we are sending. To encourage or to kill. Hallelujah. Jezebel sent a messenger not to encourage Elijah. She's supposed to encourage. Hallelujah. Ahab supposed to encourage Prophet Elijah. But Ahab turned against him. Jezebel turned against him. She sent the messenger. That's the verse. Okay. She sent the messenger.
So let the gods do to me and more also if I do not make your life as the life of one of them by tomorrow about this time.
She sent the messenger. Next verse.
And when he saw that, he rose and ran for his life and went to Beersheba.
See, she ran. He ran for his life. See, I was wondered. He took a stand against 450. But he couldn't take a stand against one woman. Amen. That is the Jezebel spirit. You can handle 450, but it's difficult to handle the Jezebel spirit. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. She gave room for the evil spirit. The evil spirit will try to kill the things of God. Hallelujah. Amen. She gave room for that. That's why she tried to kill Elijah. She sent the messenger. Amen. Hallelujah. Next verse.
But he himself went a day's journey into the wilderness and came and sat down under a broom tree and he prayed that he might die and said, it is enough. Now, Lord, take
he
my life.
He prayed that he might die and said, it is enough. Now, Lord, take my life. Hallelujah. What a sad condition of Elijah. He was able to stand against 450 and he was able to bring the fire. Now, he said, this is enough, Lord. Take my life. Sometimes, we are strong in one area. We are not strong enough in another area. Hallelujah. Yesterday, I was strong, but not today. Yesterday, I was able to bring the fire of God, but not today. Hallelujah. Yesterday, my prayer was so powerful, but not today. Now, my prayers changed. Take my life. It's enough, Lord. Many times, we are also praying like that. Because we couldn't handle the things which we are facing. Elijah handled 450, but he couldn't handle this one threatening, one fear. Right? We are also in the same path. Sometimes we felt very, sometimes we feel very strong, not another day. Hallelujah. So he, that's why he was willing to give up. Lord, this is enough. I am not righteous as like my forefathers. So take my life. Amen. But God did not give up with Elijah. That's a good news. Amen. Hallelujah. The next, we can read the next verse. Mm.
Then as he lay and slept under a broom tree, suddenly an angel touched him and said to him, arise and eat.
Suddenly, angel touched him and said to him, arise and eat. Next verse.
Mm. And he looked, and there by his head was a cake baked on coals and a jar of water. So he ate and drank and lay down again.
Amen. Good Elijah. I like him, right? He ate and drank and lay down again, because he decided, hereafter I don't want to move from this place. Let's see. This is enough. Okay, it's time to go. Whatever it comes, it's fine. I will eat and I will drink. Hallelujah. But the Bible says, the next verse.
And the angel of the Lord came back the second time.
Second
and
time.
Him.
God did not want to give up with Elijah, because God knew he was the one who took a stand for me. So I have to take a stand for him. Amen. Bible says that time God had 7,000 prophets. Elijah said, I was the one. Because Elijah did not know about the 7,000 prophets which God hidden. Okay, we can read that verse 18. Then we can come back.
Hmm. Yet I have reserved 7,000 in Israel, all whose knees have not bowed to Baal, and every mouth that has not kissed him.
Amen. Hallelujah. I have reserved 7,000 in Israel, all whose knees have not bowed to Baal, and every mouth that has not kissed him. How many people God had that time? 7,000. If God can leave Elijah, he can do that. Even though 7,000 was there, still the one is precious for God, because this one took a stand for the Lord. If you are taking a stand for the Lord, you one will be precious in the God's sight. Hallelujah. For you, God will send angels. Amen. Doesn't matter how much you are discouraged. Doesn't matter how many times you are sleeping again and again. After you receive the strength from God, God will keep sending strength from above. Amen. God sent an angel second time. God did not give up with Elijah after he sent the food first time. Amen. If I was in God's place, I will say, okay, leave him. He's not willing to get up. He's not willing to move on. Leave him. Let me do my things with 7,000. Right? But God acted in a different way. My Elijah is precious, because he took the challenge alone. He was the one praying and brought the fire of God. Amen? So God considered Elijah very precious. Amen? Hallelujah. You can tell your neighbor, you are precious. You are precious. Amen? Hallelujah. Take a stand for the Lord. Don't feel that you are alone. நான் சொல்றதெல்லாம் கண்டினியூஸாக சொல்கிறேன். யூ நீட் டு டெல். ஓகே, டோன்ட் ஃபீல் தட் யூ ஆர் அலோன். டோன்ட் ஃபீல் தட் யூ ஆர் அலோன். ஈவன் தோ யூ ஆர் அலோன், டேக் அ ஸ்டாண்ட் ஃபார் த லார்ட். ஈவன் தோ யூ ஆர் அலோன், டேக் அ ஸ்டாண்ட் ஃபார் த லார்ட். ஆமென். ஆமென். காட் வில் சென்ட் அ ஏஞ்சல் ஃபார் யூ. காட் வில் சென்ட் அ ஏஞ்சல் ஃபார் யூ. டெல் யுவர் நெய்பர், டெல் யுவர் நெய்பர், காட் வில் சென்ட். How many of you need the divine visitation? Amen. Day before yesterday, I spoke about visitation of God. I think in San Jose. Hallelujah, San Jose. Visitation of God. Amen. When you take a stand for the Lord, you will receive the divine visitation. Hallelujah. The angel of God will come for you alone. Amen. Not for the 7,000 people. God sent for this one Elijah. Amen. Hallelujah. Next verse, we can read the next verse. Mm.
And the angel of the Lord came back the second time and touched him and said, arise and eat, because the journey is too great for you.
God said, arise and eat, because the journey is too great for you. Amen. Hallelujah. Whenever I go to Woodland Hills, I will tell this verse. It's my journey is too great. I need to go back to Irvine. Okay, let me go early, right? But it will never happen. I will reach Irvine 1 o'clock in the night. Amen. Hallelujah. Some of the people learned from me. Now they are telling the same verse to me. Pastor, we have a great journey. Amen. Hallelujah. Anyway, we have a great journey for the Lord. That's why God doesn't want you to go in discouragement. That's why God doesn't want you to go into depression. Because you have a great journey for the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. The next verse.
So he arose and ate and drank, and he went in the strength of that 40 days.
He arose and ate and drank, and he went in the strength of that food 40 days and 40 nights as far as Horeb, the mountain of God. Hallelujah. How many days he walked? 40 days. How he received the strength? Because he took a stand for the Lord. Amen. When he was alone, he took a stand for the Lord. That thing brought the strength of God. Amen. Hallelujah. God won't leave you just like that. Hallelujah. God will come again and again to you to give you the strength of God. Hallelujah. That one foot from above gave him the 40-day strength. Elijah retained 40-day strength to walk up to Horeb, mountain of God. Now he reached the right place. Amen. Before, he was under the tree to finish his life. Now, with the strength of God, he was able to reach the right destiny. Amen. If you take a stand for the Lord, you will receive the strength of God. That strength will take you to the mountain of God. Hallelujah. Definitely, you will receive a mountain of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Moses went to Horeb. It's called mountain of God. Exodus chapter 3, verse 1. Hallelujah. What happened there? He saw the burning bush. Right? He received the divine visitation. Amen. From the burning bush, who spoke? God spoke. Hallelujah. Then his life was completely changed. Amen. Hallelujah. When you have a strength of God, it will take you to the right place. There, your strength will be renewed. There, you will receive the word from the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. This church is the right place to receive the visitation of God. Amen. This church is the right place for us. I include myself. This is not my church. This is church of God. Hallelujah. This is the place giving me a divine strength. Whenever you are in the right place, whenever you are in the right place or mountain of God, the presence of God, you will receive a strength of God. Amen. My desire and my and Indra's prayer is when the people walk in and go out of this place, they should go with the strength of God. They should go with the hope of God. They should be renewed by the hand of God. Amen. That is our prayer. Amen. Hallelujah. This church should not be a place for fellowship. This church should be a place for receiving the visitation of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Fellowship will prolong for only few days. Many fellowship end up with a mess up. Do you know that? The reason we are thinking I am going for fellowship. Not fellowship with God. Fellowship with people. That's why it will take your strength away from you. Whenever you know I am going to the mountain of God, you will receive the strength of God. Hallelujah. Moses received the word in the mountain of God. Moses saw the great sight in the mountain of God. The burning bush was burning, but it's not burnt away. Hallelujah. Elijah took a stand for the Lord when he was alone. Then God took a stand when he was alone. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. How many of you feel lonely? No one will raise your hand, I know. But many of you here in this place, you are thinking you are alone. You feel you are lonely. But God wants to encourage you. You are going to receive my strength. I am there for you. Hallelujah. I am there for you. I will not leave you because you are alone. You are precious in my sight. Even though I have millions of people behind me, still I need you. Amen. Hallelujah. That is the love of God. Hallelujah. Then you will receive the strength of God. Hallelujah. Then what was the end of Elijah? How he sinned? He went by fiery chariots. Amen. But he prayed for death under the small tree. Amen. Many times you are limiting your life like this. My life is under this shell. My life is under this tree. My life is just like a nirvana. No. Hallelujah. Fiery chariot, heavenly experiences are waiting for you. Hallelujah. We need to come out of the tree. Hallelujah. That's why God wants to give you strength. Amen. The glorious end was having for Elijah. He did not know that. But God wants to tell him, I have a great plans. I have a glorious end for you. So you need my strength. Amen. God gave the strength to Elijah. The same God is for you today. Amen. Don't feel that you are alone. Maybe you are alone, but still take a stand for the Lord. Lord, I will follow you with all my heart. It doesn't matter who is with me, who is going away from me. I will stand for you, Lord. Then you will receive the strength of God. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. 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 There was no one to encourage Elijah. Right? Elijah, why you are discouraged? Yesterday God answered your prayers. Yesterday you brought the fire from God, from heaven. Why you are discouraged? No one was there to talk to Elijah. But God sent one angel from heaven. Amen. Hallelujah. My son is so discouraged. You go and encourage him. Amen. When you go on the way, pick up some food and give it to him. Hallelujah. Yes. See, food came from heaven. Amen. Sometimes we'll expect this Akka needs to give food. This sister needs to give. Hallelujah. Amen. No one will bring food. Amen. Hallelujah. If they give you food, they will tell 10 people, do you know that? I gave a food. When they came from India, I gave a food. Hallelujah. But if the food comes from angel, it will give you strength. Hallelujah. Why God cut off sometime people? He wants to send us strength from above. Amen. That's why God is cutting off people. Amen. You don't need their food anymore. Stop it. Amen. Hallelujah. You need the strength from above. Hallelujah. That's why God is cutting off people. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. But we need people. We don't need to cut off. God himself will do that. Amen. Do you understand? That is the difference. Hallelujah. When God cuts it, he will give the strength. When you cut yourself, it will give you pain. When God cuts it, you don't need to go through the pain. You need to say boldly, you will know. You will know. Okay, then you need to say boldly, my strength is going to come from above. Amen. My one angel will come for me. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. I will eat and I will sleep peacefully. You are losing your sleep because of the people. You don't need to go through all this stuff, right? You can sleep peacefully. Amen? Hallelujah. I know God is ministering to you. That's why I am telling all this. Hallelujah. God wants to give you strength so that you can walk up to the mountain of God. 40 days. Amen? Hallelujah. If God permits, we can continue this message next week also. Because there is another quality in the life of Caleb, how he was able to retain the strength. We saw only two things. Caleb took a stand for the Lord. Caleb was not having a manipulating or double standard life. Amen. Whatever he had in his heart, he was able to speak out for the truth. That is important. Amen. Hallelujah. He was able to speak out for truth. Amen. Sometimes we need to speak out for the truth. Hallelujah. But many times we are speaking up speaking against the truth. We are not talking for the truth. But God has called us to talk for take a stand and talk for truth. Amen. Elijah took a stand. Hallelujah. He challenged the people. Amen. Bible says he repaired the altar. He asked the people to come and help him. Bible says there was no one. Hallelujah. Everybody kept quiet. He asked, if the Lord is Lord, follow him. If the Baal is Lord, follow him. Amen. Bible says, but people kept quiet. They did not say anything. But still, the next verse will say, Elijah repaired the altar. Even though he did not have any support, he himself repaired the altar. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Then the fire of God came upon that altar. Hallelujah. Who built the altar? Elijah built the altar. Who repaired the altar? Elijah. How many people? One. Hallelujah. God wants to encourage you. You build your altar. You build the altar of prayer. I will bring the fire from above. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's stand up. Hallelujah.